driving through Karen now, coming out of Patterson Lakes. We've got a cool for a day. Sun's shining. The wind's about to die right off, hopefully, and the bay should glass out a little bit, which will make it ideal for a quick little squid session. Try and get a few quick calamaris for a bit of a feed tonight. And then we're going to head out a bit deeper to about 18 metres off Mount Eliza and use soft plastics and lures, try and get a few little pinkies off the reefs there. So hopefully the wind dies off and it's glass for us. So we're just here in Davies Bay or Oliver's Hill, just going for some squid. It's a little bit quiet today. The water's pretty murky, so not having too much luck, but consistency will catch you more fish. So we just need to stick in there, stay patient, and we'll get a couple. We'll find them. So we've hooked up here on Hook, Line and Sinclair. We're not all about meat. We do like a bit of vegetation on the plate, so we've got us a bit of sea salad, yum, with a bit of broccoli, bit of garlic butter, delicious.
Yo, give me something to dance to.
Do another one here. Not massive, but it's still a fish, still a calamari. Get the net ready here. Hopefully he doesn't cover me in his black juice. Not too bad this one. Here we go. Look at that. Hey. So when I'm going for squid, the rods that I'll use is I tend to go for graphite rods because they're a lot stiffer and they let the jig work better. If you got this rod's a fiberglass and you can see how bendy the tip is. Just when you get a squid on, they can pop themselves off because of the flex in the rod. So it's better to have a stiff, nice stiff rod so that when you whip that jig, the jig really darts. The line I use for my main line, it's got to be braid. Just mono's just no good. It doesn't do what you want it to do. There's too much stretch in it. You can't feel the jig at the end of the rod. So I always use braid. I won't go lighter than 4 pounds because that's pretty light. You know, if you do snag up a lot and the jigs, you know, cost 15, 20, 25 bucks each. You don't want to be losing jigs because your line keeps snapping. So I'll generally run at sort of 6 to 8 pounds. You can go heavier if you want. And then I'll use a knot to join the braid to the leader. And then with the leader, I'm always using a fluorocarbon leader. Just underwater, it's virtually invisible. And squid have pretty good eyes. And if you're using a real heavy leader, it can spook them. And, you know, your hookup rate might not be as good as with a nice light leader. So can sort of see how thin the line is there. This is a 6 pound fluoro by Shimano. It's Oceart. It's really good stuff. So always using braid, only using knots. I'll never have swivels or jig clips or anything. I reckon it doesn't allow the jig to swim as naturally if you've got sort of more weight on your line. So always just using knots. Take your time to get your knots right. Nothing worse than losing fish to some bad knots. Heartbreaking stuff it is. So yeah, spend your time, get your knots right, and you'll catch the fish. I'll fish all day with that one knot, and it works fine. So you get the connection right and you're in business. So this spot is pretty quiet today. We've only got the two in about half an hour. So I reckon I'm gonna move around the corner here. There's quite a few more shallow reefs that just run the whole way up the coastline. So we're gonna make a move, I reckon, at the end of this drift. The way that I sort of will find my squid spots is I'll look on Google Images, on Google Maps, and I'll have it on satellite mode. And from the photo of the satellite looking down, you can actually see up to about 6 or 8 meters through the water, and you can see where there's patches of reef and sand. So I kind of just will have a scan along the coast, find where there's some reef, and I'll try and mark it on my phone or get the coordinates off my phone and pop them into the sounder. So there's quite a few good looking reefs just around that corner. So I reckon at the end of this drift, we're gonna get them in and make a move, try a different spot. So just at the new spot here, and we've got another one. Not a bad model, this guy. Hey, there he goes. Hey! Coming up. Oh! Not a bad calamari, this guy. Just get the net out here. Not a bad fish at all. Oh. There we go. Alrighty, now we're just gonna get away from the rocks because we're in about a meter and a half. Yeah, so the first drift at the new spot, we've got a nice one there. Nice hood, he's not bad at all. So I guess it shows like we weren't getting fish at that other spot. So move locations, try a new area. First drift, nice squid. Yep, on here. Just a little guy. There he goes. Hey, he's just hooked by one tentacle. Definitely gonna get the net on this guy. Hey, we're on again. Double hook up here. Oh, the other one sounds all right. Quickly, there he goes. Quick, grab it. And the other hook up's a snag. So we're only in about 3 meters here. So the jigs sink pretty quickly, about a meter every 3 or 4 seconds. So I'm literally letting it hit the water, let it sink for about 5 seconds, then just a few whips. Let it sink, leave it. Just wind that slack out, but don't put tension on the jig, and then whip it. Leave it, let it sink back down. You can try different techniques throughout the day. Sometimes you'll find, you know, the quicker retrieve might be getting them. Sometimes you'll find the slower retrieve might be getting them. Find what they're doing that day and then keep doing it. You'll find that you will get squid after squid. Just a few more casts here. We're gonna do about another two casts and then call that it for squid. We've got plenty for the plate. There's about five or so in the live bait tank, so that's plenty for a feed. But yeah, good to find some pinkies and try and get a few pinkies on the soft plastics. Always great fun. There's no need to come out and bag out on squid every time. There's just no point. I mean, you can freeze them and use them for bait later on, but it's always better just to come get a couple each session while they're fresh. So yeah, we just finished the squid session. We've caught a few nice ones for the feed tonight. They're not too bad. That guy's pretty decent. The couple of smallies as well. These are really good eating. The flesh on them is so thin. It's you can nearly eat it raw. I'm not gonna, but you nearly could. Along this part of the coastline here, there's heaps of reefs. So there's gonna be squid everywhere. There's actually a little beach called Sunnyside Beach. I think it's a nudist beach. I don't actually. It's got heaps of squid, but I don't like fishing there because you're just staring at old blokes laying naked on the beach. There's nothing worse than looking at her wrinkly bum cheeks while you're trying to catch a few calamari. So try and steer clear of Sunnyside Beach. But up next, we're gonna go out a little bit deeper and try and fish on some reefs using soft plastics. So the plastics that I've got in store for today are some gulps. I'm just using these little sort of 3/8 inch minnow smelts. The colour's smelt. Another really good colour is watermelon pearl. It's a natural looking colour. Like they almost look like, you know, little pilchards nearly. So they do dominate. And then some other really good plastics are these little crabs. These just get nailed. Just these little crabs. Whether it's, you know, I haven't used them targeting sort of bigger snapper or gummies, but I really do reckon that they would take them, but only time can tell. All right, so we went out a bit deeper, couldn't sound any fish up on the mark, so I'm coming back shallow where I did sound a few arches. So I am going to be using a soft plastic, but I'm going to have one bait rod out. So just using the normal running rig, got the easy slider to the swivel, to your leader, to your hook. Pretty straightforward. There's not massive fish. We're just going for pinkie, so I'm just gonna use small baits. So I'll just put just cut a little strip here. That's plenty right there, just enough so that they just come along and engulf it. One hit. We don't want them nibbling at it. We just want them just to take the bait. So I'll cast him out. We've got I've got a bit of a burly trail going, so hopefully if there is a few fish around, they'll come to the back of the boat and hold. We're only in 5 or 6 meters, so don't need to let too much line out. That's on the bottom there. Just wind it tight, make sure the sinker's holding on the bottom. Lovely. Whack him in the rod holder. And now with the soft plastic, so I'm using these gulp minnows. Just these guys in this smelt colour, so it's a pretty natural looking colour. So to put it on the jig head, simply just, it's pretty important to get them on right so that they swim naturally. So you want the hook coming out perfectly so that it stays straight. So I'll see where the hook's coming out and then I'll feed it through the nose there. Take your time when doing it because it you need to get it on right, otherwise they don't swim nicely. So it's just like that, feed him on there. So as you can see, that's not on well. So what I'm gonna do is I just rip the tail slightly just until it sits nice and straight. And that'll do us. So that bait rod is getting nibbles quite hard. I might, before I cast that out, I should be right. If it hooks up, we'll know about it. She won't go anywhere. So I'm just gonna cast this out into my burly trail. Let it get down to the bottom. And I'll just do simple just winds. I'll lift it and let it sink. A bit different to squidgy, I'm not whipping it. I'm just lifting it. And then let it flutter back down to the bottom, just naturally, like it's a bait fish that's injured. Just they come up and then they flutter back down. That's on this other rod with the bait. Pretty lucky actually. It's not a bad fish. He's given me a little bit of curry actually. I might Might have to get the net for this one. I shouldn't talk too soon. Keep that line tight. When he wants to run, let him. Just let him go. Let him run. Just keep that line tight. When you're fighting the fish, either he's running or you're getting line back. Don't leave it at the stalemate. You just keep bringing him up. When he wants to go, let him go. Keep bringing him up. He sees, wants to go, I'm just gonna let him. Here he comes. I can see him down there in the water. He doesn't want to come up. Oh yeah, so it's a size pinkie there. That's not a bad one. Pretty decent start there. Just gonna bring him straight up. Oh, he's foul hooked at that guy. So I've actually foul hooked him. So there he goes. Now he's coming home. That's some dinner right there. So be real careful of their spikes. I'm just gonna double measure him just to make sure his size. What's that? 32. So their size is 28. That's 32. Perfect. That's your pinky snapper right there. This size is almost nicer than your big snapper. These guys hold, just wrapped in foil, whack them on the barbecue for 20 minutes. Absolutely delicious. Let's see if we can get a few more. Hooked up again on the bait rod. So we're just bringing him in, probably another pinky. Took off like a steam train, but slowed down a bit. There he is, not a bad fish at all. So I'm definitely gonna net this guy. He's actually a bit bigger than the last guy. Hopefully I can get him into the boat. Bit hard on this whiting rod. Oh, there he goes. Come here, mate. Come on. Lovely. All right. So that's pinky number two. He's a little bit bigger than that first one. Try and get this hook out of him without hurting him. I might let this guy go. We've already got one for dinner tonight, so that'll do. But might give him a quick measure. See what. So that's 36, that guy. So he's not bad at all. Look at the blue on the top of his eye there. Isn't that just amazing? And the spots down their body. Such a gorgeous fish. I bloody love him. So we'll let him swim off here. Let him just swim off by himself. Go on, mate. There he goes. Rebait him. So I'm just gonna, again, simply like that. No need for anything fancy. Just pin it once through the top. Let the bait flutter around in the water. Just gonna put him back out there and whack him back in the rod hold. I've got no idea what the plastic's doing at the moment. I just left it there. Hopefully it hasn't snagged up on a big rock or some weeds. But again, there must be a school under us because I can't even get this on the bottom. I'm just gonna leave it in the holder. I'm gonna let him hook himself up. So I've got my burley bucket down here at the back. And I'm just, every now and then, I'm just giving it a mince. You can see all the good burley in there. You can see it clouding out the back. So we'll bring this plastic back in and see if we can get a pinky on the plastic. I'm gonna cast this plastic out here. Let him sink down. Oh, it looks like that other rod's getting a few bites, but we'll, all right, that's on. That other rod's on for sure there. So it's not as big as the last guy. Oh, it's a different species. What's that? So we've got a red mullet here, a little goat fish. These are actually really good eating fish. If you, I've done a bit of research on them. Back in the ancient Egyptian days, these were an absolute delicacy, these fish. They're quite a tropical looking species. You can see the blue across their eyes there, and they get the name the goat fish because they've got these little dangly things under their chin. So really, really nice eating. There's no size limit, but he's pretty small, so we'll let him go. I try and handle fish without breaking their scales off, because I think it can cause them a bit of damage. So I'll just let him swim away there. Go on, buddy. Off you go. You just want to hang out with us, do you? There he goes. Fun. So we'll get this bait back out again. So the bait's absolutely dominating here. I should probably keep the bait out so that I can try and get one on the soft plastic. But when the fish are biting, it's hard to stop. Pinning it through once, that's it. No more. Little cast out. Let it get to the bottom. And then bring it off the bottom so it's not stuck in mud. Let it hit back down. Straighten the rod holder. Bob is your uncle. Straight away, if you keep your eye on this rod, you can just see it just getting hit instantly. Look at that. All right, getting a few nibbles on the plastic here. All right, I've hooked up on the plastic. So I've just take it nice and easy. I've only got 6 pound leader on here, so I've really got to take it easy on these pinkies. Oh, he's not a bad little guy, quite this guy. Here he comes. Beautiful. Whee. There he is. So that was one on the plastics. Just going to lift him straight in. He's not size. He might just be size, but we're not going to keep this guy. So just get that hook out. Nice hook through the jaw there. Another nice little pinky, and off he goes. See ya, buddy. So I'm just working this plastic along. Lift it up off the bottom. Let him flutter his way back down. Quite often they will take it on the drop. So you'll be letting it drop, and then all of a sudden your line just tightens up and you know you're on. So just set the hook and start fighting him. Softy back out there, right up the back of the Burley Trail. So I'm just letting it sink. I'm keeping an eye on my line in case it rips instantly, so I know it means there's fish go on it. Oh, I can feel them straight away. They're just onto it straight away. All I'm doing is just slowly winding here. Then I'm gonna stop, let it sink, and keep winding. There we go, got one on. Not a bad one either, this guy. God, there's so much fun on this light gear. So I've just tangled myself up here. There we go, freed him. Lovely little fish. Bonk. Lucky there, the plastic's still just holding on. I may as well leave him on there. So again, nice long cast out into the burley trail, as far as you can. Let it sink down. And bring it up. Just taking it nice and easy. You don't need to work the soft plastics fast. All right, we're on again. Come on, mate, open your mouth, let the hook out. I'll tell you what, if I could have one of these guys as a pet, I reckon I would. I'd love to get home every day and him going, "Hey Nick, how are you, mate? How was work today, all right? Oh, that's the way. What's for dinner tonight, eh? Maybe a bit of pilchard, some silver whiting." So we've got our last pinkie here. We're going to finish up after this one. Get him in the boat. Just a little sucker to finish the day off. Hopefully I'll catch him in about 10 years when he's weighing about 8 kilos or so. That would be lovely. Fair hooked. Should be all right. Just drop him back in there. Off he goes. That's it. Soft plastic session's over. It's only about 4:30. We were going to stay till sundown, but we've got some squid, got some pinkie for the feed. Had a great time. Ready for dinner. Let's pack it up. Get home before the sun's down. Lovely. So just on our way back into Carrum now, to Paterson River. The conditions right now are perfect. It's what dreams are made of. The way that it's glassed out here doesn't happen too often, but when it does, you may as well make the most of it. Get out on the water. It's making the drive home an absolute dream. Had a good little start on a couple of squid. They're a bit slow, but still got a few. And then yeah, I was lucky to get a few pinkies. It took a good probably half an hour to an hour to actually sound them up and find some to fish. There's no point in sort of just dropping the anchor anywhere and just fishing and hoping. There's no point in fishing where there's no fish. You may as well spend the time, move around and find them. Most of the time, when you find them and you anchor on top of them, you'll be getting on straight away. There's no waiting around for them. So you put in that extra time to find them and you will get lots of fish.